Hello mate, how's it going? Welcome back to another video. This video is going to be a Murdock build guide and it's based on the cheat sheets from JellyKnees. You can find JellyKnees on Twitch, YouTube and Twitter under the username JellyKnees. I'll leave all of his social media in the description. And enough of that crap, let's get into the video. So here we are, carry. Default Murdock skin. It's a little bit painstaking, but anyways, these are the cheat sheets by JellyKnees that you can see on screen. I'll have all the links in the description. The one we're focusing on today is obviously Murdock, so we're going to start off with the spring and a health potion. So on the right lane, I didn't actually have a support. And I was up against what definitely felt like a duo queue support carry, which is very common. Twin Blast is getting very aggressive because they're setting me up for the old switch-swoo thunk. They pushed, Twin Blast was trying to get the kill. I managed to secure the kill on him using my health potion now. And just gonna grab a few minion kills. So here we are not long after, and as you can see we got two people in the mid lane. I think we had two people on our team that were new to the game, so that's why I didn't have a support. But you know, these things happen.
People an ally has been slain
somewhere. So we go back for our first buy. So we're going for boots. Ideally, we're going to get Hunt fully leveled first, and then after that, it'll be the P Blade. So here we are on the right lane again, doing a real good job of killing off my minions, enabling them to push me with their minions. And I've noticed they've gone for raptors here, and I don't just charge in. Just need to make sure that they're definitely out raptors. I see them marginally. They're not focused on me at all. I go in, get thunked. I leave my shield for the very last moment. I don't get him far enough away.
An enemy has been slain.
Narbash, and then I duel it out. Twin Blast decides that he's had enough, and I just chase
double
him down.
Kill.
In that situation, he would have been better to try and duel me to the end, because Murdock can chase you down when you're on low HP. So we're going to get another few minion kills. I believe currently at the moment, Murdock has the highest HP scaling out of all of the carries. It makes him very strong. You see here, I noticed I come towards the raptors and my alarms went off.
Been slain.
So I instantly knew that there was someone
an
at
ally
raptors.
Has been slain.
Gave me easy kill, easy raptors. And then looks like we're just gonna head back. We've got a good chunk of money, and this gives us time to spend our favor and start working towards some more items. We're going to get closer to that P Blade as our second item, and then we're going to spend that short change on a base item for the AI ammunition item. So they really want to push down that Chimera. I catch the Twin Blast out at the back, but somehow they've managed to turn it around. I try to shield at the last minute again, I don't get out of it. Too much stun going on, and then a thunk, and then a third. And that was all she wrote.
An ally
so
has
going
been
out
slain.
Nice
ally
and fresh now.
Destroyed.
I've noticed that the enemy Chimera is in our jungle. I'm working my way there, secure the kill on our Chimera. And then he starts duking with our Gideon, and Gideon's just kiting him. At this point, I'm feeling like it's just going to be an easy kill. He could have peeled off to kill me.
An ally has been slain. Decided to go for the easy kill.
And Narbash was waiting to join in, and he's like, no thanks, mate. So, I can see there is a lot of shit going down on mid lane. I'm going to run over there. Gideon, one of the new guys, unfortunately, doesn't really have a clue what he's doing. It doesn't do too bad, though. So, Twin Blast gets absolutely destroyed.
An enemy has been slain.
Chip away at Narbash a little bit. It's not going to be enough. He does manage to get into the safety of his tower. Our Gideon is tower diving for no reason and gets absolutely annihilated. We got a good amount of gold now. There's not much else happening here. But we're going to hover around to see if they do push. They're backing. It's a good time for me to back. So, enemy Chimera was chasing down our Chimera. And he gets absolutely annihilated. Almost takes me with him though. Chimera's E ability is really strong. It shreds carries. Absolutely shreds carries. I ult the Countess here just to assist with the damage so we can secure the kill. And she manages to get away with no HP. And we finally get that P-Blade. And we get a little bit closer towards the AI ammunition. So here we are again, going into mid. I'm starting to really feel
an ally has been
these
slain.
Items working in synergy with my left mouse click. Chimera uses his leap. I saved my shield especially for that.
Kill.
Pick up the double kill. Narbash is in no man's land. Secures the triple kill.
Triple kill.
Starting to really snowball. These cheat sheets are absolutely genius. I think they're a rough meta. I think there's definitely still other options for different situations. And I definitely think that there
enemy
is different
tower
builds
destroyed.
For different playstyles. However, these cheat sheets are a rough enough meta to get you through most games being quite strong, so long as you're racking up those last hits and farming your gold. So the Countess has destroyed
slain.
Our Chimera. But in return, she also gets absolutely annihilated. She tries to ult Bellica, but it just puts her in a very, very unfavoured situation with a carry still lurking around. Giving this Chimera a bit of poke damage. Pretty much annihilating him. Going to ult him to finish him off.
And
then we're going to take this tower.
Enemy tower destroyed.
So, here we are, just grabbing our AI ammunition. And then the full metal jacket, we get the base item. It's going to be our fourth item that we're working on.
An allied tower is under attack.
So now is as good a time as any. If you want to join in with the shenanigans, come catch me. twitch.tv/mckenshikaze. Try to stream 2 to 3 nights a week, and his twin blast caught out of position.
An takes enemy has not been very slain. Many
shots to the back, and he's gone. Non-existent. The Gideon's getting worried, gets stunned, and his HP had no chance whatsoever. He's going to bite the dust.
An enemy has been slain.
Doing some insane crits. Able to get really good poke damage. Really, really starting to get that power snowball. Again, our Gideon is tanking the tower. He does not realise that the red line means death as the Countess jumps in on me. Bellica takes the tower damage.
Enemy has been
and
slain.
Securing the kill on the Narbash with my ultimate. Countess is backing. And then decides not to back. We're actually being ganked. Bellica's stuns are absolutely
enemy has been
insane
slain.
This game. She saved my butt yet again. This Countess is looking to jump on me and eat me alive. That's one ability away from death, and that's all she wrote.
An enemy has been slain.
So the Bellica ults the Countess, but the tower finishes her off, and I get the kill. So I think I get baited hard here, yeah. I chase the Gideon and then Countess from behind, and it does not take her long.
An
Countess
enemy
bites
has
the
been
dust,
slain.
But at this point, it is too late. They did good, indeed. Looking for a gank on middle. I know that I can take this Twin Blast, staying well away as he goes for Raptors. Decides, nope, messed up. Good thunk through the shadow there. Trying to decide what's going on. Narbash gets stunned out of his ult, and then I just pop the question, will you be another number on my scoreboard? Gideon gets absolutely annihilated. Getting low on HP now, but I'm going to pick up. I thought I'd pick up the double kill. I guess I get a double kill. Could have been a triple kill, and then the Countess just eats me like Weetabix. So here we are working on our King's Castle, which is one of our final items. There is also the Adrenaline Boost, which would be the sixth item that we can get once we sell that health pot and have enough money. Unfortunately, we don't get to see a full build. Trying to figure out if they're at all prime. Greystone takes a moment to think about it. Chooses to go and have a look. And there is nothing there. So, going to help push out this mid lane. We've got right lane set. Left lane, I think, is set against us. But I'm feeling really confident at this point in the game. I've got a good lead on all of the enemy heroes with regards to farm and favor. Gonna set left lane before we go for a gank somewhere else. The HP scaling on the siege minions is quite high. But you see, when I crit the range minions, I am able to one-shot them.
An ally
so
has been slain.
Gideon again in mid lane got absolutely annihilated by the enemy team. I'm going to show up late. Better late than never. Stop these minions from pushing the tower. Greystone is getting in the middle of everything, so he's Narbash has used his thunk. Countess is dodging. She's looking to get the kill on me. She didn't go the other way. Narbash is gonna get annihilated.
Enemy has been slain. Enemy has been slain.
Gonna kill this Gideon because his HP is just weak, and then we're gonna
get a triple kill
on the Chimera, and we're gonna finish it off with a quadra kill on the Countess. Almost a pentakill. Somebody else got the Twin Blast. So we're gonna attack mid lane and right lane, and that will be all she wrote. So let me know if you've enjoyed this type of video. It's a bit different for me. I don't want to do just a complete guide. I want to take the cheat sheets that have been provided by JellyKnees and put them into some gameplay footage and just talk about the actual game and how it's going. Anyway, thanks for watching.